Daytime baseball here on MLB Network. Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Cincinnati Reds. Hello again, everybody. Baseball is back. Welcome to our special opening day broadcast on MLB Network. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. The staffs for these two teams sure to be a focal point as this series moves along.
You know, I always think pitching and defense are the keys to success in the long run. So as the season gets started, it's going to be really important for this pitching staff to set a good tone. If they can get off on a good foot, it will do a lot for the confidence of the entire ball club.
The games count starting now. Opening day on MLB Network, and it's coming up next. Getting close to first pitch here. Let's listen in to public address announcer Alex Miniak. Quickly now, a look at the two men who are entrusted with the starting pitching assignment here to begin the new year. A chance here to check out the starting lineup for the visiting Pirates. Mark, what do you have on this lineup as they go for their first win?
Well, Matty, if I could tell this lineup one thing, it would be let's get on this guy early. Day game in this ballpark, the sun starts glaring, starts getting later in the day, those shadows start creeping in right around the time that bullpen starts getting warmed up. Gotta find a way to scratch a few across early.
Alex Wood gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, taking a look at the numbers, you see that ERA a little under 4 last season. But I think his team and organization, they're expecting some bigger and better things out of him this year. We'll see if he can get off to a better start in this one.
Time for a look at the Cincinnati Reds on D. And let's focus our attention on first baseman Joey Votto. I don't think this guy gets enough credit for his defense because he's so dynamic on the offensive side, but one of the most prepared players in our sport, and half of that is definitely attributed to the defensive side of the ball.
Digging in, Starling Marte. He will lead this one off today. The 1-2. And it's fouled away. Sunshine starting to break through a bit after a cloudy morning. 57 degrees here at game time. Again, a 1-2. Still 1-2. Fouled off. The next 1-2 pitch. Grounded weakly toward third. He's got a hurry. Throw, and he's called out on a close play at third. So the next to the plate for Pittsburgh, Melky Cabrera. Here it comes on 1-1. Swing and he pops him up. Jeanette is there for it. He's got it, and there are two down now. And that'll bring in Adam Frazier. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Into his motion. Here comes the 3-1. Swing, strike two.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
just underway here in Cincinnati. Hit on the ground out toward Jeanette at second. Reined in. Throw on to Votto will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. So a rather pedestrian start to the top half of the first. Now it'll be the Reds' turn, no score. Time now for a look at the hometown Reds starting lineup card in this one. Nero, give us what you have on this lineup as they start a new series.
Matty, you take a look at this lineup. I find myself thinking back to my playing days when I knew I had the ace on the mound. It had to be win day, and when you get in a car to drive to the yard, you tell yourself, even though you felt bad about it, just get two or three. All the pressure's on the big boy to have to execute, and he usually does. Look for this lineup to try and execute and score, manufacture one or two runs early in this one. Time for a look at the Buccos on D. And let's take a look at the guy behind the dish, and that's Francisco Cervelli, one of the best ball framers in all our sport, a guy who's going to make his pitcher work for everything today.
And here's Jose Peraza. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1. Strike two swinging.
That pitch just had too much velocity on it for you to catch up to that. Unless you're cheating to a high fastball above the belt and you're all in, I say you got to find a way to lower your sights or it's going to be a tough game.
1-2 pitch is a slider that misses. 2-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Another strikeout for him on the mound, and boy, is it fun to watch him go about his business.
No doubt, Matty. He's one of my favorites, mostly because of his stuff. You know, he can absolutely dominate on any given day because of what he offers up there. It's just nasty. There aren't many hitters that like to see this guy on the mound.
Stepping in now, Jesse Winker. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
The main job of the number one and two hitters is to set the middle of the order up with an opportunity to do some damage. So when you strike both of them out, you're putting yourself in a pretty good position to make it through the teeth of the lineup without a whole lot of stress.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And the Reds have their first hit of the season.
A little two-out lightning right there, Dan, in the first inning. Let's see if the cleanup hitter's got anything in store.
Boy, what looked like such an easy and a promising easy inning for the pitcher. Now he has to deal with the Thunder, the cleanup hitter coming up.
Into the box now, Eugenio Suarez. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Taillon, he's the kind of pitcher that a lot of pitching coaches and managers really appreciate, and that he rarely issues the free pass. He's a strike thrower.
Yeah, Matty V, and I think every pitching coach and every manager loves to have a guy like this on his staff. He won't beat himself, but make you put the ball.
Now, meanwhile here, this ball's hit fairly well down that left field line, and it's going to stay fair. It's a home run. So a two-run homer down the line in left. First home run of the campaign for him, and it's given Cincinnati a 2-0 lead. No doubt an impressive home run, so we'll employ ShowTrack for a more in-depth look. 112 miles an hour was the exit velocity off the bat, so it's no wonder why it ended up having the impressive distance that it did. In now, Scooter Jeanette. Line drive to center field. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
One team's dream inning is another team's nightmare, right? That's their third hit of this opening inning, this one a double. That's got to have the pitcher pretty upset out there and the manager wondering how long he's going to go on this one.
Standing in now, Matt Kemp. Swung on, but it's pulled foul wide of third.
Oh, that's frustrating right there. He was right on that fastball, took it deep, just couldn't keep it fair. How many times have you seen it? There's a good chance he's punching out right here.
And the slider misses here, so he runs the count full, 3-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Swing, and he's able to flare this one out to left. And this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner. And the runner from second is in to score.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. Two-strike RBI base hit. The ball wasn't hit very hard, D-Row, but from a hitter's perspective, you'll take it any way you can get it.
Yeah, in today's day and age where everyone's looking to go deep and can go deep, not many guys have a legitimate two-strike approach. This is one of those players, and that's exactly what he did. Shortened his stroke a little bit, didn't try and do too much, and came through for the team.
And it's 1-2. Time for a look at our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is James Kingsley.
Dan, I know I was an offensive player, but I'm okay being a pitcher's umpire. If you're going to consistently pound that outer half, James Kingsley's usually going to give it to you.
Hey, listen, there's a reason why the pitchers throughout the league, they call him the king of the hill. You move the ball a little bit off the strike zone, he's not afraid to put that arm up. He's a very good pitcher's umpire.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as this side is retired. But they strike for three in the inning, two on this two-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 3-0 Cincinnati. Up next for the Buccos, Corey Dickerson. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
The 1-2. This is lined to left. And the Pirates are into the hit column for the first time this year.
Boy, D-Row, anytime a lefty takes that pitch on the outer third and drives it the other way, you have to be awfully impressed.
Yeah, you have to be. It reminds me of Will Clark back in the day taking that ball the other way. You have to be able to play with the whole field to have success in the big leagues today.
Into the box, Francisco Cervelli. And this pitch is popped straight up right around the home plate area. And he'll lunge forward to make the catch for the first out. Josh Bell the next to hit. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. The set and the 1-1 pitch. 1-2 now as that's in there at the knees. Wood, a 6'4 lefty. He was taken in the second round during the first-year player draft of 2012.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes.
3-2.
Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now. 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Count still full. 3-2. The next 3-2. On the ground to third. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. And a nice job to stay with it that time and get the second out of the inning. So striding forward now, Colin Moran, runner in scoring position with two gone. A good action on the two-seamer there, and it's 1-2. Dickerson at second with two down. No, just down. A bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2. The 2-2. Still even at 2-2. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And another foul ball. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full. 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Popped him up. Barnhart shading to his right, and that ends the inning. Pirates leave one. They trail in this one 3-0. Ready now for Cincinnati, Tucker Barnhart, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. Two balls and two strikes to the Reds catcher. The 2-2 one more time. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time is looked at, and the count moves full.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
Ground ball left side, and that'll get by into left field, so he's on to lead off the inning.
Hey, the offense did their homework coming into this one. They have another leadoff knock in the second. That makes five hits already for these guys.
Stepping in now, Alex Wood. And they'll indeed have the pitcher squaring around as he puts this one down. Only plays to first, so the pitcher does his job as it's a successful sacrifice. A man at second with one down, and digging into bat next, it'll be Jose Peraza. And they fires a line drive. Base hit to left field. Herb comes into third now, so they're at the corners here with only one out.
Wow, and the hits just keep piling up for them. Take a look at the numbers here. That's already six hits, and we're only in the second inning. We'll see if they can keep this up as the innings go on.
Stepping in, Jesse Winker. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Loop down towards short. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score. In is Joey Votto now. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield, he's going to wave them.
Peraza stands at second with two gone. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Boy, the curveball just hasn't been there this afternoon, and this is this guy's bread and butter pitch, especially when he gets ahead of hitters. He needs to find that curveball again.
The 2-1 home doesn't hit the target. It's ball three.
They know the threat this guy possesses at the plate. I know it's 3-1 in this situation right here, but I can't imagine anything comes over the heart of the plate.
Pitch is piling up, 44, and he's not clear of the second yet. Fastball is taken for a strike, and he runs it full, 3-2.
You know he wants to end this inning right here on 3-2, but I don't think we'll see him lay one in on the next pitch there with a base open to work with.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. It's a run on two hits here for Cincinnati. We played two full. It's the Reds 4 and the Pirates nothing. Leading off the inning, Kevin Kramer, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
Winker, a range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out. One away now in the Pittsburgh third, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Jameson Taillon. Hit the target, but this is low, 2-1.
Well, these are just extra pitches that are just going to add to your pitch count. He's not trying to work around him, and no reason to, but sometimes you just lose the strike zone for no apparent reason.
Ball even at 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Ground ball right side, fielded by Votto, and they'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. Stepping into the box, Starling Marte. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Calling for it, Puig. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. They're down 4-0. Check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to talk about the state of the Reds offense with their manager between innings, and flat out he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already put 4 runs on the board, and they've done so by running up their opponent's pitch count. So he said he thinks they're going to have a lot more opportunities to score because of that as the game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. So now the Reds' cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. He hit a 2-run jack in his first at-bat.
Yeah, Matt, and going back to that last at-bat when he hit the homer, that was a fastball that was up in the zone. This guy likes the ball up in the zone, so if I'm on the mound right now, I'm thinking try to keep the ball at the knees and below. He doesn't handle that low pitch quite as well.
shoots this one over to first. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And a great job to stick with it here as he gets the first out of the inning. So the base is empty here with one away. And up to hit next, a guy who's turned into a big-time RBI man, Scooter Gennett. The 1-1 home. Fly ball to straightaway left. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. In now for the Reds, Matt Kemp. He reached on a single in his first try. Now the 1-1 pitch. Misses, ball two. Two out, nobody on. And a big swing and a miss here, two strikes.
Super important situation right here for the pitcher to go 1-2-3. Get back in the dugout, regroup. He struggled early, but if he can knock out this 1-2-3 inning, I think he can right the ship.
Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Pretty easy pitch to lay off there, 2-2. Not even close to being in the strike zone. He made it easy for the hitter on that one.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. They walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Into the box now, Yasiel Puig. Line drive to center field. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Reds leave one, but they're in front 4-0. Digging in now, Melky Cabrera. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. To 1-2 now. The 1-2 pitch. Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. The 1-2. Jammed him there as this is rolled out to short. Peraza scoops it up. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth. Ready for another chance? Adam Frazier. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-1. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. In time to first, and there are two away.
Oh, that'll make you smile as a pitcher. You make a good pitch, you blow the guy's bat up, and then you make the play yourself. In your head, you're thinking, nice swing, mate.
Next to bat will be the Pittsburgh cleanup batter, Corey Dickerson. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. Wood into the windup. 2-1 on its way. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw goes to Votto over at first. It's in time to retire the side. Down in order go the Pirates. They trail here 4-0. Standing in, Tucker Barnhart. We'll begin things here against Jameson Taillon.
Even though they're up by a boatload early on in this one, you can't get complacent and get lazy. They got to keep the gas pedal down because this team that they're playing can strike and score a lot of runs too.
The 1-1 is laid off for ball two.
Been a real big struggle for him so far on the mound. Four runs and only three innings, so it'll be interesting to see if he can settle in at all and make some adjustments, or if this start will continue to run downhill.
And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now. And this pitch is taken high and away to fill the count. It's 3-2. And that misses for ball four. The leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth. So here's the Reds pitcher, Alex Wood. He did his job and laid down the successful sack bunt in his first appearance.
And not easy to do in today's game. High velocity, exploding breaking stuff. He executed that sack bunt perfectly.
The 1-1. Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground.
Let's go. Wait for the pitch.
And a bunt attempt here with two strikes that'll get foul, so he'll become out number one.
I like how he worked him backwards for that strike out there. He wasn't showing the fastball early in the at-bat, but then went back-to-back once he had the hitter down in the count.
Standing in now, Jose Peraza, fouled away. Ripped on the ground to first. There's one. The relay on to first. The double play, and the side is retired. Boy, oh boy. Nothing across here this half of the inning. On to the top of inning number five we go. The Reds are on top, 4-0. And back in Cincinnati as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Clint Hurdle during the commercial break about the Pirates offense, and he told me overall he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi. In now, Francisco Cervelli. He's 0-for-1 thus far.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going, and the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Two balls and a strike now. The 2-1. Back up the middle. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
We take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up two hits so far today, so he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward, but I'm not betting against him.
Digging in for his second at bat, Josh Bell. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. 2-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
As a hitter, you know the pitcher's trying to work you down around the knees in a double play situation, so making him get a pitch up and actually in the zone is a must.
The 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Cervelli gets his lead at first, nobody out. Changeup misses, and it's full 3-2. payoff pitch one more time. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 3-2 one more time, and he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Well, he loses them there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits. So his command has been pretty solid so far.
Now batting, Colin Moran, 0-for-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
No runs, two hits, and no errors so far for the Pirates. Still a ball and two strikes.
Hey, I don't mind you throwing a fastball in this situation, but I think, if we're being honest with ourselves, that one caught a little bit too much of the plate.
Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
At the plate, Kevin Kramer. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Now the 2-1 to third. Fielded cleanly. A tag for one. Relay to Votto's in time at first, and it's a double play. Side retired. One left for Pittsburgh. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Now at the plate, Jesse Winker will start things off here for Cincinnati with Joey Votto to follow next. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three balls and a strike to the Reds left fielder. There's Joey Votto as he gets ready in the on deck circle. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Count remains full. Another full count pitch home. And that misses ball four now. It's a leadoff walk to get the home half of the fifth underway.
And this is exactly what you want to do when you're trying to put a start away. Make him work his tail off, throw a lot of pitches, and get on base any way that you can. A big inning at this point of the game, and he's probably gone.
Tyler Lyons takes the ball here as he'll enter with a runner at first and nobody out. Joey Votto will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out. Now the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a grounder fouled off to the left. Six hits and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. And this is swung on and missed by Votto, and he's retired for the first out.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone. And when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
Yeah. In now, Eugenio Suarez. Ground ball foul down the left side. Winker leads off first with one away. Now a shot sent off to the right side to foul.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away. Here's the second baseman, Scooter Gennett, in head-to-head action against Tyler Lyons. He's just 1-for-13. He's also been a strikeout victim six times. Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Always tough for one of these base umpires to make a call on a guy's check swing. It's not a great angle, and everything happens so quickly, so they really have to be paying attention out there. Looking at the replay, I think he got it right, so that's a tip of the cap for the Blue.
Stepping in now, Matt Kemp. Line towards center field, and the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Reds strand a couple, but they hold a 4-0 lead. Elias Diaz will grab a bat and lead things off here in the top of the sixth. Ripped down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Weed coming on. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Here's Starling Marte. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A ball and two strikes. Well off the plate with the change of pace. That's ball two. One out, nobody on. And a 3-2 full count to Starling Marte. Melky Cabrera will be next. Three-two pitch. This pitch is popped up. Suarez calls for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Into the box now, Melky Cabrera. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Bases are empty here with two men out. Two balls and a strike to Melky Cabrera.
Hey, you can tell by the look on that manager's face, he's obviously frustrated right now. But it's a long season. You're going to have a lot of ebbs and flows with your offense. Does he take a step back and relax a little bit, or does he call a team meeting right after this one?
A swing and a high drive to right center field. Back goes Puig, and he makes a nice catch on the track as that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. They're down 4-0. Michael Feliz enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth. In now is Yasiel Puig. No hits to this point. Oh. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
Well, the 1-2 pitch didn't go his way, and now a miss there on 2-2. You know he doesn't want this at bat to get away from, so I think we're going to see a challenge pitch on a full count.
Hard hit ball to second, scooped up on the backhand, and he will whip this one over to first in time for the out. Coming to the plate now, Tucker Barnhart. His career numbers in this matchup, he's a perfect 2-for-2. Now the 1-1 pitch. Liner towards second. And that's in for a base hit, his second in as many trips to the plate.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 hole hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you could swing the bat.
Into the box now, Alex Wood. Got it back in time there, and it's 2-1.
Great decision there to pull back. Step number one in getting a sacrifice bunt down, make sure you bunt a pitch that you can handle.
And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. But this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. Second, 4-6-3 on a nice dig at first, and the inning is over. Reds go down quietly. They lead it 4-0. Back here at Great American Ballpark in Cincinnati. Reds leading this one as we start the seventh, and before we commence, let's take a look at the game summary to this point. So stepping in, Adam Frazier, 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
Down the third baseline. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
I'll tell you right now, this guy has a shutout going, and it's been all business. He's not messing around trying to pick at corners. He's being aggressive in the zone, and he's attacking each and every one of these hitters up to this point.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Corey Dickerson, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Hey, that's another nice two-seamer right there. He's been able to manipulate that pitch all game, keeping it at the hollow of the knee, getting a lot of ground balls and a lot of swing and miss.
The 1-2. Count still at 1-2.
Man, he's going to be kicking himself when he goes and watches the video after this one. That's a changeup, two strikes in the wheelhouse. You cannot miss that pitch.
They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2.
And it's late to his afternoon of work, and the longer this at bat goes, the better chance of him making a mistake. But as a guy starts to tire, they're more likely to leave the ball up. But man, he's been good so far.
Line drive to left. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Dan, you have to love it when your defense picks you up right there, keeping him at first base.
Boy, D-Roll, that looked like it had extra bases written all over it. Great job by the left fielder to get to that ball and get the ball back in, keeping that to a single.
Stepping into the box, Francisco Cervelli popped out and singled in his two trips to the plate. Dickerson, a runner at first with one gone in the inning. Now that's popped up. Therefore, it is Votto, two away now. Striding into the box, Josh Bell. It was a walk in his last trip. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. And this one's in the dirt. And a good idea to hang close at first, as he'll make it back easily. Two out with the man at first. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. And that one is gone on a two-strike count with two away in the inning. Two runs on the board after that home run by Josh Bell. First home run of the campaign for him, and the Bucks have made this a 4-2 game now.
Yeah, he had the right idea trying to bust him inside, but that pitch caught too much of the plate, and he took it deep for a two-run homer. That was a nice swing of the bat.
Here comes the Red skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and we're going to have a pitching change, as that's going to be off for his starter this afternoon. So a good performance here in this one, as he'll give a tip of the cap to the home crowd after he departs, yielding just two earned runs. So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Standing in now, Colin Moran. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Two out, nobody on. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys, so we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. But the Pirates do get a couple here on this two-run home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's the Reds 4 and the Pirates 2. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Jose Peraza. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Swing and a liner. And that'll slice just foul at the last moment. The 2-2. And it's fouled away. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
That was a good job there of using the batter's aggressiveness against him. He was putting up a good fight and fouling a lot of balls off. So as a pitcher, it's a great idea to expand the zone even more and make the hitter really chase after something that's even hard to foul off.
In now, Jesse Winker. A swing and a ground ball to third. Moran takes it in, and there's out number two. St- Stepping up now, Joey Votto. Lifetime versus this pitcher. He's 0 for 4. He pulls this one into right, and a knock for him this time. He's 2 for 4 for the game.
He got the pitch he wanted, and he didn't miss it right there. Hammer job.
Stepping up to the plate, Eugenio Suarez. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you could extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
Votto leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss. Good eye to lay off the slider there, and he works it to full 3-2 here.
Full count with two outs now, so if he could put the ball in the gap somewhere, he could have a good shot of driving in a run because the runner at first will be in motion.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Fouled off. The 3-2 one more time. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. One left for Cincinnati as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Leading off the inning, Kevin Kramer, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
I got 3-1.
Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
The 3-1 pitch, and a good take there will net him a base runner as it's ball four now to start the eighth inning.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you, so we'll see if that's the case here.
Lonnie Chisenhall will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Matt Bowman enters the game out of the bullpen now, and this will force the upcoming switch hitter to swing the bat left-handed.
Well, I think this is a smart move, guys. He's pretty well known that he's less of a threat from the left side of the plate, so this could prove to be a good job of playing the matchups.
Into the box, Starling Marte. The high fastball is in there. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. Ready with the 2-2. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full, 3-2.
Yeah.
And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
And you can tell by his body language that he's beyond frustrated by that call. He's got to be wondering what he's got to do, but the last thing he needs to do is to let it get under his skin. That will only make things worse.
Kevin Newman will come on now and pinch run here. Now at the plate, Melky Cabrera. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Runners are at first and second with one away. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Winker has a play, two down. Stepping in, Adam Frazier. And Dan, this could be a real make or break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
Ball and two strikes now. Is put in play to the right side of the infield. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Pirates strand a couple. Still down by a count of 4-2. Kevin Newman will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop. Richard Rodriguez is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. Settling in now, Scooter Gennett. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
This is on the ground over to first, and he'll step on first himself for the out. So one away here in the Reds' half of the eighth, and that'll bring in the powerful center fielder, Matt Kemp. He stays alive, still 2-2. Bases are empty, one man out. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
Stepping in now, Yasiel Puig. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now.
Didn't catch the corner there, but you can see he was trying to jam in with that running action on that two-seam fastball.
Bases are empty here with two men out. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. Reds are down in order, but they still lead this one 4-2. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Raisel Iglesias comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. batting in to start the ninth, Corey Dickerson, and they'll need him to get something going here.
Looking for base runners here as they're down two playing on the road. Not an easy thing to do, trying to score runs or bunch hits together off of a closer.
Now the 2-1. Go right on, but this is foul down toward the box at third. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. Full count still. The next 3-2 is a called third strike right on the inside corner.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
One out, nobody on. Line hard to center field, and he's going to make the play over toward his right, and there are two away now. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Josh Bell, his lifetime numbers against Iglesias, he's gone 2 for 6. It's two balls and a strike to Josh Bell. Two out, nobody on. Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. Running hard, he's digging for second.
Well, the pitcher gives up the double. He can't do anything about that now. He just needs to put it behind him and focus on the man at the plate. If he takes care of him, the game is over. On the other hand, if he gives up a bomb, this thing is tied. It's getting a little dicey.
Standing in now, Colin Moran, 2-1.
Watching him on the mound right now, I think he's just having trouble throwing strikes to this guy. Up only two runs, I don't think he's working around him.
Now the 2-1 is taken, ball three.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
Three and one pitch. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. Pittsburgh down to their last strike. Count still full, 3-2. A crowd of just over 42,000 on their feet here in the Queen City. That's lifted the other way out to left. He makes the catch, and the Reds move to 1-0 on the young season as this ball game is over.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
4-2, the final score today. The Cincinnati Reds posted a 3-run first to propel them to the win. Alex Wood gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Jameson Taillon was only able to work 4 innings as he takes the loss. Raisel Iglesias records the save, his first of the year. So that's a wrap for us in this one. Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, Matt Vasgersian, we all thank you for watching Major League Baseball on MLB Network. See you next time.